Okay, so what we have seen just now is that basically even the ideal processor that can execute any number of instructions per cycle still has to obey raw dependencies, meaning it still has to wait for results to be produced before they can be used by instructions that need those results. And that really creates some of the delays that the ideal processors are going to have, and that's why the ILP is not zero. It's going to be something larger than zero, even for an ideal processor. So let us now look at some instructions. So let's say that I1 is producing a value that is used by I2, and then I3 is producing a value for I4, and then I4 produces a value that is used for I5. So what is going to be the CPI for this particular program? Well, it's going to be CPI is equal. How many cycles do we need for these five instructions? Well, here's what's going to happen. I1 can execute immediately in the first cycle, and so can I3 because it doesn't have to wait for anything. So we spend one cycle executing I1 and I3. The next cycle, I2 can now go, and I4 can also go because I3 is now done. And then we still need a third cycle to execute I5, which has to wait for I4. So we have spent three cycles for five instructions, which is going to be a CPI of 0.6. So the CPI is still lower than one, but now it's even larger. And finally, if we did have this dependence as well, now we have to do I1 and then I2 and then I3 and then I4 and then I5. So now the CPI with this is going to be 1. Why? Well, because we need 5 cycles to execute 5 instructions, so the CPI is going to be 1. So basically, in the program, the dependencies, the raw dependencies are going to determine basically what is the possible CPI, even if the processor can do everything else ideally, meaning it can fetch any number of instructions, it can decode and read registers in any number of instructions, but it simply cannot provide time travel, which is kind of the only consideration that we really consider in this case. It's just that, you know, we cannot do time travel. Everything else we can do, we still have a CPI that is somewhere between 1 and 0. You would have a CPI of 0 if you have a very large number of instructions with no dependencies. We have seen that. We have a CPI of 1 if you have any number of instructions that are all dependent on the previous instructions, so you really cannot do anything in parallel.